Strength. It's a word that probably calls to mind things that are big, tough, impenetrable. But to scientists, strength may look a little more like this. It may not seem like much, but these wetlands are incredibly resilient. Mangroves, marshes, sand dunes, coral reefs, and other natural structures. Scientists call these living shorelines, the coastline's natural protection against high tides and storm surges. And with nearly 50% of Americans projected to live along the coast by 2020, rising seas could affect millions of people. Until recently, tall, rigid structures were the preferred means of coastal defense.
A lot of the infrastructure is very vertical, like seawalls and pier piles and even breakwaters. And vertical orientation really compresses a whole habitat into a very narrow belt.
Imagine that a wave is like a fist. It collects a tremendous amount of energy as it rushes for the coastline. A seawall's job is to block that punch from making landfall. But seawalls, levees, and other industrial structures are expensive and require a lot of upkeep. And even while maintained, a direct hit can cause them to fail. 14% of the US coastline is already lined with these structures. Living shorelines are cheaper and can be just as effective. Their pliable, sprawling nature allows them to absorb a blow from a rough wave and bounce back quickly. They also attract plants and animals.
As opposed to having a flat wall or a flat precast element that doesn't invite anything, it's boring, it's homogeneous.
Shorelines teeming with life have the ability to regenerate and grow. They may even keep pace with sea level rise without additional cost. The concept is gaining popularity. The Army Corps of Engineers is considering a new permit category that would speed up natural shoreline construction. And some coastline cities are already putting plans into motion. Green systems aren't right for every place that needs to fend off storm surges. But combined with concrete structures, living shorelines will provide a 1-2 punch to help protect millions of Americans from the effects of rising seas.